Hi students, good morning everyone. So yesterday, that is in our last class, we have started the second unit. In the second unit, we have started the first topic, that is partial correlation. So we have seen what is partial correlation. So partial correlation means eliminating the linear effect of the third variable on the two variables and finding the partial relationship between two variables is called partial correlation. So we have considered a trivariate data, and on that we have seen three partial correlation coefficients. So we have seen a problem how to calculate the partial correlation coefficients if already the correlation coefficients, that is R12, R13 and R23 are given. Now today we will start multiple correlation coefficient. So under correlation only, it is the next topic under the correlation itself, that is multiple correlation coefficient. So here multiple correlation coefficient means, the name indicates that multiple, that means we'll have many. So the joint correlation coefficient or the joint relationship between the group of variables on the variable which is not included in the group is called multiple correlation coefficient. So multiple correlation coefficient is the joint effect of group of variables on a particular variable which is not included in that group, So here I am considering a small example about the yield of the crop. If you consider the yield of the crop, so yield of the crop means whatever the output you are getting in the agriculture field is called yield of the crop. So this yield of the crop, it is dependent on many other factors, right? Suppose the quality of the seeds, it is dependent on the quality of seeds. Yes, right, on the weather conditions. So it depends on the climate also. Always the agriculture depends on the climate. So it depends on the weather conditions. So it depends on many other things like the quality of the seeds and the weather conditions and the fertilizers also. So whatever the fertilizers we use on our crop, that also impacts the yield of the crop. So here if you observe, this yield of the crop is dependent on the different variables. Suppose this is my yield of the crop, I am representing with the variable x1. So yield of the crop I am representing with the variable x1, so which is dependent on the quality of the seeds x2, or the weather conditions x3, or the fertilizers x4, or it is also dependent on the irrigation facilities. So if you consider irrigation, that will be the x5 variable. So similarly, there will be other factors also which will be influencing the yield of the variable. Suppose if you are finding the joint effect, so these all constitute one group, right? The quality of the seeds, weather condition, fertilizers, irrigation. So these are all from one group, that is, which is related to the agriculture. So these all belong to one group. So if you are finding the joint effect of different variables upon the other variable, so all these variables are influencing the other variable, right? So if you are finding the relationship or the joint effect of a group of variable upon the variable which is not included in the group, is called multiple correlation coefficient. There is nothing confusion here. If we are finding the joint effect, that is whatever it is dependent. All these are the independent variable. This is the dependent, right? So here, this is not included in this group. It is dependent on this group, but it is not included in that group. So if you are finding the joint effect of a group of variables upon a one variable, upon any one variable which is not included in the group, that is called a multiple correlation. So what are the multiple correlation? Now here, multiple correlation coefficient, it is denoted with capital R, and here for the first variable I am finding. So multiple correlation means 1 dot upon the variables 2, 3, 4, 5. So that can be written as 1 dot 2, 3, 4, 5. So here the variable 1 is dependent on these all four variables, and we are finding the joint effect of these four variables upon this one variable. So this is multiple correlation coefficient. It is denoted with R 1 dot, whatever the dependent variable or the on which we are finding the joint effect, that will be written first, dot all the group variables after the dot are written. So here also, same like partial correlation, here also we will be seeing only about the trivariate data. Now we will see what is multiple correlation coefficient. This is about the multiple correlation. Now we will see the multiple correlation coefficient. So here also I am considering a trivariate data. So trivariate data will be having three variables, that are x1, x2 and x3. So these are the three variables which consist of n values. So three variables will be considered which will be having the n observations. Then the multiple correlation coefficient, so first I'll see about the first variable. The multiple correlation coefficient of x1, so I'll see for the first variable of x1 on x2 and x3. So here we are finding the joint effect of x2 and x3 on the x1. So the divided by 1 minus, here you have 2, 3, so 1 minus 2, 3 square. So this is R1.23 square. If you want to write in terms of R1.23, you can simply apply square root to this, you will get R1.23 value. So this is the multiple correlation coefficient of x1 on x2 and x3. Now we will write this similarly, the multiple correlation coefficient. Now I consider x2, the multiple correlation coefficient of x2 on what are the remaining variables? x1 and x3. It is denoted as R, then considering of x2. So you will get 2.13. So the formula is given as R2.13 square equals to return combination, that is R12 square R23 square minus 2R12, R13 and R23 divided by 1 minus this one R13 square. So this is the multiple correlation coefficient of the variable x2 on the x1 and x3. So if you are writing only R2.13, you will apply the square. So this is the multiple correlation coefficient of x2 on x1 and x3. So similarly, now we will write the multiple correlation coefficient.
Measures the closeness of associations.
observed and expected values. Between the observed and the expected values. So how we will be getting this expected values? By multiple linear regression. By multiple linear regression. So this is the first property of the multiple correlation coefficient, that it measures the closeness of association between the variables. That means it measures the association between the observed values. Observed values means the values which are given already, or whatever the data we have collected, that original values are called the observed values, and whereas the expected values which we have estimated, so it helps to measure the association between our observed values and the expected values. Next, coming to the second property. So second property is, it is related to the first property only. So whenever you are calculating the multiple correlation coefficient, there you are taking the joint effect, right? So if you are considering the multiple correlation coefficient for the linear regression purpose, then the expected values will be very greatly, will be having the much more value than from the other linear regression. So instead of taking multiple correlation coefficient, if you take other, that will not give the much efficient. So whatever the expected values are there, that are greater. So whatever the expected values we have calculated using the multiple correlation coefficients have the greater efficiency than compared to other, greater than the other linear regressions. So if you consider simple linear regression compared to that, the multiple regression values will have the more greater accuracy than the other values. Next, coming to the third property, is that the correlation, multiple correlation coefficient always lies between 0 and 1. So always the multiple correlation coefficient, it lies between 0 and 1. So here I took R1.23, or it may be any way, any multiple correlation, that is R2.13 also lies between 0 and 1. Similarly, the third one, that is R3.12, also lies between the 0 and 1. So the limits of the multiple correlation coefficient are 0 and 1. So here, if you observe that if R1.23 value is exactly equals to 1. So whenever this R1.23 value is exactly 1, then the association between them is perfect. Then the association, here the association means the relationship. The association between them means between the variables. The association between the variables is perfect. So how we will identify the correlation coefficient by seeing the R value? Similarly like that, if you are R1.23, or it may be either R2.13 or R3.12, it may be any value, it is equals to 1, then the association between those variables is said to be the perfect association. Next, the fifth property is, so similarly, if R1.23 equals to 0, then the total or the partial effect of this first variable, we are finding for R1.23. So the total or the partial correlation, including the one, that is including x1. So here wherever you are including r1, 2 or 1, 3. The first variable value. So that total or the partial correlation value might be 0. So this is the fifth property. Next, the last property, that is sixth property, is r1 dot 2, 3 is always greater than or equals to r12, r13 and r23. So if you consider the multiple correlation coefficient, that will be always greater than or equal to the product of the correlation coefficients between the three variables, that is the combinations of two variables, that is the joint three variables. So these are the different properties of multiple correlation coefficient. The first one is it measures the closeness of association between the observed and the expected values by the multiple regression analysis. Second one is this multiple correlation coefficient between the observed and expected values, when the expected values are calculated by the is always greater than where the expected value is calculated from the other linear combination of variables. Next, similarly, third one, that is the multiple correlation limits, that it lies between 0 and 1. Similarly, if the correlation coefficient, multiple correlation coefficient is 1, then the association is said to be perfect. And if it is 0, then we say that the partial correlation coefficient including this x1 variable might be 0. Next, r1.23 is always greater than or equals to r12, r13 and r13. Not only r1.23, even if you consider r2.13 or r3.12, that will be greater than or equals to this same terms. So this is the properties, are the properties of multiple correlation coefficients. Now next, we will see a small problem related to multiple correlation coefficient. So how we have done the problem for the partial correlation coefficient? In the same way, we will be doing the multiple correlation coefficient only, just substituting the given values in the required formula. So this is a simplified problem for the partial and multiple correlations. Generally, if x1, x2, x3 are given, we will be first finding r12, r13 and r23. Then we will be substituting those values in the partial and multiple correlation formulas. Now we will see a problem related to it. So coming to the problem, the question is, find the multiple correlation coefficients of r1.23, r2.13 and r3.12. If the data is given as r12 equals to 0.77, r13 equals to 0.72 and r23 equals to 0.52. So for this given data, we have to calculate the multiple correlation coefficients. So first write down the given values. Given that r12 equals to 0.77, r13 equals to 0.72, similarly r23 equals to 0.52. Now first, the multiple correlation coefficient, so first I am finding the multiple correlation coefficient, that is r1.23. 1.23 means the multiple correlation coefficient of first variable x1 on the joint effect of x2, x3. So r square 1.23 is given as r12 square plus r13 square minus 2r12, r13 and r23 divided by 1 minus r23 square. So this is the formula. Now substitute the values. You will get r12 value is 0.77 square plus 0.13 square. R13 is 0.72 square minus 2 into r12 is 0.7 0.52 divided by 1 minus R23 value is 0.52 square. Now solve this one. We will get the required multiple correlation coefficient, that is 0.77 square is 0.5929 plus 0.72 square is 0.5184 minus 2 into 0.77 into 0.72 into 0.52, it is 0.5766. So this value is constant in all the formulas. Remember this value as 0.5766 divided by 1 minus 0.52 square. So we will be getting as 0.7296. Now solve the numerator. 0.5929 plus 0.5184 minus 0.5766. So numerator value is 0.5347 divided by 0.7296. So this is R square 1.23 value. Now similarly, now find the square root of that one. So R square 1.23 equals to, divide those two terms, 0.5347. 0.5347 divided by 0.7296, that is 0.7329. So square root of that answer, you will get the R 1.23 value as square root of the required one is 0.8561. So multiple correlation coefficient always lies between 0 and 1. So you should not get any negative answer. If you get negative answer, you are doing somewhere a mistake. So this is the multiple correlation coefficient of R 1.23. Similarly, we will find the next one. Next is second one, that is multiple correlation coefficient. Multiple correlation coefficient. Next I am finding R 2.13. So coming to R 2.13, write down the formula. R square 2.13 equals to R 12 square plus R 23 square minus 2 R 12 R 13 R 23 divided by 1 minus R 13 square. So this is the formula. Substitute the values. First is R 12 square, that is 0.77 square, plus R 23 is 0.52 square minus 2 into 0.77 into 0.52 into 0.72 divided by 1 minus 0.72 square. So 0.77 square plus 0.52 square is 0.8633 minus, this value is constant, that is 0.5766. 0.5766 divided by 1 minus 0.72 square is 0.4816. Now solve with one, 0.8673 minus 0.5766 divided by 0.4816. So you are getting R square 2.13 equals to 0.5953. So apply square root to it, you will be getting the R 2.13 value as 0.7716. So this is the multiple correlation coefficient of the x1 and x3 on the x2. Similarly, we will find the third one, the multiple correlation coefficient of R 3.12. r23 square minus 2r12 r13 r23 divided by 1 minus r12 square. Substitute the values. r13 is 0.72 square plus r23 is 0.52 square minus 2 into 0.72 into 0.52 into 0.77 divided by 1 minus 0.77 square. Find out the value. 0.72 square plus 0.52 square, it is 0.788 minus this value is constant, that is 0.5766 divided by 1 minus 0.77 square, that is 0.4071. Now 0.788 minus 0.5766, that answer divided by 0.4071, you will be getting as r square 3.12 equals to 0.5212. So apply square root to 8, you will get r3.12 equals to 0.722. So these are the required multiple correlation coefficients for the given trivariate data. So today we have seen the definition of multiple correlation coefficient. If you are not understanding, just check the example I have given. So if you see the example, you will understand the definition of multiple correlation coefficient better. So we have seen the different properties of multiple correlation coefficient, and we have seen a simplified problem for the multiple correlation coefficient.